Well, talk to yourself now.
Mohammed was so afraid.
He stopped you.
He was so afraid.
I am not.
He was so afraid that Muslims would leave Islam.
I am not Hashim. I read the book.
He would leave Islam.
Rubbish book.
He was so afraid. What did he do? He would bribe Muslims.
Paul wrote.
Yes.
14 of the New Testament.
I've got to read.
Paul.
Paul. Look at the desperation of his life.
Paul. Paul wrote 14 books of the New Testament.
Come over here.
He's a criminal. Paul was a murderer. Paul was a criminal.
Now,
he was a murderer.
Everyone knows
Paul was a
that
criminal.
The mafia,
Paul was a
once
murderer.
He joined the mafia,
Paul was a murderer. He was a criminal.
The Cosa Nostra,
he wrote 14 books.
The Godfather, he would try to put everybody with power in his pocket by bribery.
He wrote the New Testament.
And if you wanted to leave the Cosa Nostra,
you
would be threatened with death.
Why you follow a criminal?
This is Muhammad.
Paul was a criminal.
He's a 7th century godfather.
Was
and I'm going to prove to you Paul. That he had to bribe people
he was a
to join Islam.
He was a murderer. Yeah. Right. He wrote 14 books of the New Testament.
Zahir.
Why do you follow up?
Zahir Bukhari.
Follow him.
I love this game. Zahir Bukhari 455 558. So the Quraysh and the Ansar became angry. And said he of Najd and does not give us, talking about money. The Prophet said, I give them so as to attract their hearts to Islam. Do you have to pay people to join Islam? Muhammad had to do it. He doesn't stop. He doesn't stop there. He doesn't stop there. Ibn Ishaq, the life of Muhammad. 594, the apostle gave gifts to those whose hearts were to be won over. Notably the chiefs of the army, to win them and through and to win them through as people.
To win someone over is slang anyway.
People wanted to leave because they realized that Muhammad was a sham. They realized that Islam was a sham and they wanted to leave. So what did Muhammad do? He bribed them to stay. I'm going to read this. This is from Sahih Bukhari. I'm still speaking to him.
It sounds like you're talking to me.
I am. Sahih Bukhari 224 556. Oh Allah's apostle, why have you left that person? By Allah, I consider him a believer. The Prophet said, or merely a Muslim. Then Allah's apostle said, I give to a person while another is dearer to me for fear that he may be thrown into hellfire in his face. So he's afraid that people are going to become apostates, so he gives them gifts.
I have no idea what you're talking about. He's saying to win someone over.
I'll just quote it to you.
To win someone over.
I'll quote it to you, Ibn Ishaq. I've quoted you Al-Tabari, I've quoted to you Sahih Bukhari.
Well,
Muhammad is bribing people to join
and
bribing people to stay. And not only is he doing that, he's telling you that if you leave Islam, you must be killed.
No, that's not true.
You want me to read that scripture?
Prove it. Again.
You haven't heard that?
No,
you genuinely haven't heard that?
Let's bring a legend.
He knows it's true.
The punishment for a possible reason.
No, it's true, brother.
No.
So he's Muslim, he's got you in bondage. Muslim, he's got you in bondage. He's got you in bondage. You need to come to Jesus Christ.
No, you can't speak.
The only gift that he's got to give you is the free gift of eternal life. The free gift of eternal life from this man here to you, brother. He's not trying to bribe you with money. He's not lying to you. He's not afraid that you're going to leave.
You sound like
you're saying, yeah, but
you put himself
on a cross.
You just contradicted yourself.
Willingly.
You just contradicted yourself.
Willingly.
You don't have to speak, are you? You're not going to let no one
speak. He knew that he could call. He could call 12,000 angels.
Only one God, the Lord, everybody.
He could call 12,000 angels to help him, but he refused.
If I don't believe in Jesus,
because he wanted to go to the cross to save you. And to save you. As much as you mock.
And
he wanted to go to the cross to save you. As much as you mock. Every Muslim here. And the free gift that Jesus has given you is eternal life. Just believe in him. Believe in who he is. Believe in his death and resurrection, and you will be saved.
But there's one condition, isn't it?
All that I have is liar.
Your free giveaway. Your free giveaway is one condition.
You liar.
What's the condition?
If I don't believe in Jesus, the eternal life, our Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, then I'm going to hell.
Yeah.
So clearly, it's not free, is it? It comes with one.
Listen, brother. Listen.
The gift.
He's a liar.
The Bible says the wages
of... It's not a gift, innit, if I have to pay...
You want an answer? This is why I speak to everybody. Do you want an answer?
Go on, let's get it.
The Bible says the wages of sin... The Bible says the wages of sin is death.
What do you mean? How many?
We are all sinners.
How many?
Hear me out.
All Muslims have one.
We are all sinners. Me and you.
Al-Quran al-Kareem.
And if God must punish sin, the Bible says the wages, what you get paid for sin, is death. God didn't want to put us to death. So he gave his only begotten son, so that whoever believes in him shall not perish with that penalty of death, but have eternal life. So he's given you a free gift, but you must believe in Jesus. But you don't have to pay. It's free.
Do you want God
to force you into heaven?
It comes with a condition.
Do you want God to force you into heaven?
But I'd rather be in heaven.
I'm asking you a question.
Do you think
it's better if God gave you a free will, showed you that he is God by all the work?
Listen,
we're talking.
God.
Do you think it's better that God gave you a free will that you see by all his miracles?
That he rose from the dead,
yeah? That he is God and saying, believe in me, and he's given you the free will to do that. Do you think it's better he does that? Or he forces you and takes you by the scruff of the neck and drags you into heaven?
My free will?
Which is better?
I'd rather be forced by the neck.
La ilaha illallah.
Now you're sensible. You know that's a ridiculous
thing. The reason I'm saying,
he's prepared to be dragged, kicking and screaming into heaven rather than having free will.
Liar!
This is why. Thank you. So be honest.
You're twisting it.
You know.
If I was to follow your concept, I'm getting dragged, right? And I ain't getting dragged there, I'm getting dragged to hell.
You only have to believe in him.
I only have to believe in him. It's not free, is it?
It is free. It's a gift. The gift is eternal life.
If I say to you, brother, I'll give you a bottle of water, but you've got to shake my hand. Yeah? I'll give you the bottle of water, but you've got to shake my hand. No, I don't want to give you the bottle of water because it's not free.
I'll give you a hand.
Do you hear this? Did you hear the question I've been asking Muslims all day? You're going to go to hell and burn.
Am I?
Yeah. According to your Islamic scripture.
Where's my free gift?
Are you looking forward to burning in hell?
I'm not looking forward to it.
It's scripture.
I know, but why would he burn in hell?
Every believer, including you, brother, every believer in Islam is going to burn in hellfire.
Who says this?
And not one Muslim has come to me today and given me a refute for that. I've quoted you three Islamic scripture, two, and Muslim, saying that every Muslim is going to be thrown into hellfire and all their body is going to be burned up. The only thing that's going to be left is a mark of prostration. Are you looking forward to burning?
I think you're wrong.
We can tell. His words are true.
I think you're wrong, brother. Every man will be judged on his doing.
Because we can judge you.
Why is Jesus coming?
Why are you following a man like this? That gives you this kind of promise.
You had a dream. You had a dream.
Every man will be judged on his doing.
No sensible answer.
You had a dream.
No sensible answer.
You're not listening to
me. Every man will be judged on his own doing.
That's not what your prophet says.
That's what the Quran says.
Jesus white. Why you pray for him? They show you Jesus.
Let me tell you.
They told you Jesus white.
Muslims, God loves you, but you're following a ridiculous man that's saying ridiculous things. And all you have to do, all you can do is laugh.
We're laughing at you, man.
Right?
We're laughing at you.
He's my son.
We're laughing at you. What's coming out?
You can laugh at me, brother. That's good.
Honestly,
Jesus said that I'd be laughed at.
You see, you're confused.
Jesus said I'd be ridiculed.
No, listen.
I don't mind.
You're confused.
Jesus, he's son of God.
People try to get in my space and talk about all this kind of rubbish around me. Right? There is one name given unto heaven whereby you must be saved, my friend. You can't intimidate me. No one can intimidate me. I stand in the presence of the Lord God Almighty. He's in me, he lives in me, the Holy Spirit. It's a free gift. Jesus sent it to me. So we are not your dimmy. I'm not your dimmy. And I'm not your dimmy.
No one's a dimwit.
Okay? Now listen, guys. Let's stop playing the power game.
Find that truth.
Let's stop to playing the power game. Let's talk about the kind of things.
6 years old.
No, no, no.
The things that Jesus said.
Separate God from religion.
Let's talk about 6 years old.
The things that Jesus said. Jesus said beautiful things. He said beautiful things. That love your enemies. Pray for those who despitefully use you.
Give me holy water.
We know all story.
Pursue peace with all mankind. So no matter if you're laughing and you're cussing and you call me all kinds of evil names, I'm commanded by God to pursue peace with you. Hallelujah. This is the real teaching of God. The teaching of Jesus. Love, forgiveness and mercy.
Amen.
Whereas if you go to the teaching of the Quran, you're taught to hate unbelievers because we are najis. Filthy. Yeah? Come on, Muslims. Muhammad told Muslims that when they recite the Quran, that it's so beautiful.
Say it.
It's so beautiful that they should cry. And if they don't have the ability to cry, they should fake it. This is what Muhammad said. Who's going to call me a liar?
You're a liar.
This is how Islam is the religion of deception, from head to foot.
Where did you get that from?
You don't believe in Sunnah because you're Shia.
Ah.
This is talking to the 80% of Muslim believers. I'll read it to you now. Sa'id bin Uba Abu Waqas. Sa'id bin Abu Waqas.
Can't understand you.
All those Arabic speakers can't probably pronounce it better than me. But you get the picture. Came to us, this man who I can't pronounce, came to us, this is saying, when he had become blind. I greeted him with salam. And when he said, who are you? So I told him, and he said, welcome, O son, my brother. I have heard that you recite the Quran in a beautiful voice. I heard the Messenger of Allah say, this Quran was revealed with sorrow. So when you recite it, then weep. If you cannot weep, then you should pretend to weep. And make your voice melodious in reciting it. This is what your prophet said. Your prophet's telling you to deceive people by how beautiful the recitation of the Quran is.
Muhammad didn't say that.
If you all Muslims.
If you want
all Muslims.
Challenge.
Come out of Islam.
Quran.
Jesus was found without any sin. There was no guile found in him. Scripture says there was no guile found in him. No deception. He is the truth. He is the way. He is the life. I'm going to end this discussion right now because I have no answers as usual.
He created Christ.
I love you, bro. I love you, bro.